I'm going to be reacting to Freddie Mercury Funny Moments Part 1. This was requested on YouTube, and I can't wait to see this because I've probably seen bits and pieces of it, but I don't think I've seen the full thing, so let's get started.
Everybody looks at me on stage and they think that's how I am, like arrogant and that's the way I know. And when you look at me now, I'm quite boring, really.
No, you're not. Freddie, you're not boring.
Hi, my name's Kim Basinger. I'm Freddie Mercury. I don't know if they want us to go. Do you want us to go?
The audio is better in certain parts than other parts. Like, some videos are louder than the other ones.
Half an hour. Half a minute. I could get married and divorced in that time. Just to fight like kids. Every time I'm in the same room with Brian, in 5 minutes we sort of...
Sparks fly.
Yeah. I haven't hit him yet. But there's still time.
How does it feel? It's the end of a day like that. Do you like your job? After an evening like that?
I love my job, but I hate talking to people like you. We were just checking into one of the hotels and we realized that Bohemian Rhapsody had gone to number one. Four of us were in a lift jumping up and down and the fucking lift stopped. So there we are. I thought, my God, here's the number one group in England. They're going to suffocate in this damn lift.
Oh my goodness.
I hardly read books. That's a waste of time. People are going to kill me for this.
So the rest of the guys have houses in LA. I assume you mean the other members of Queen.
Yeah, what do you think of that?
What are their names again?
Stop that shit. It's Brian, Roger,
and
John.
Roger and John, yes.
I sometimes forget these two.
Listen, if you guys want to move around and shift your asses a little, it's okay. It's okay by us, right? You can take all your clothes off if you like to. Fuck off.
Oh my goodness, when he said you can take all your clothes off, it doesn't matter. They play under pressure, that's hilarious.
We all do different things. They'll lead me to just the wardrobe, I guess.
The wardrobe.
They'll lead me to the wardrobe and writing the hits.
Now what happened?
I think most people thought that I would be the first one to have a solo album and then the band would, Queen would break up and all that. But here you are, after 13 years. Four old ladies are still rocking away.
You missed the rest of the guys.
No.
Because
he's
the leader of the band.
I'm not the leader of the band, by the way.
No?
Yeah, everybody calls me the leader of the band. I'm just the lead singer. And, I'm not a general or anything. Four members, and they seem to call me the leader of the band, but I'm just the lead vocalist.
Isso, né, ser um líder do Queen, quer dizer, você tem problema de relacionamento com os quatro por ser o líder do grupo?
Yes, I am the leader of the group, yes. I'm fucking honest.
You think you're going to get to heaven? No, I don't want to.
Yeah.
No, hell is much better. Look at the interesting people that you're going to meet down there.
Oh my goodness.
You're going to be there too, you know.
Who plays on the album? Is there any sort of surprise guest?
Yeah, me. What about the actual work in the studio when you four come together and everybody wants to bring his side of songs?
Yeah, that happens all the time, yeah.
It sounds like having also...
It's like a cockfight, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, we've four cocks fighting. God, it's getting nice, this.
Oh my goodness.
One day we were in the control room and Fred was sat at the desk and suddenly we heard this voice, and it was Sid Vicious who'd come in.
Oh, wow.
It was clearly the worst of wear.
Sid came in, Sid was a moron, you know, he was an idiot.
And he called into the room, have you succeeded in bringing ballet to the masses yet?
Mm. I called Sid Vicious, and I called him Simon Ferocious or something.
Simon Ferocious.
I said, what are you going to do about it?
Fred went up, took him by the lapels, pushed him out the door.
He hated the fact that I could even speak like that.
Right.
Wow.
Then,
so we went. I think we survived that test.
Well, you're done, 17, and you want to do it disappear.
a surprise for the Brazilian people in the Rock and Roll Festival?
The best one, yeah, it's me. I am the surprise.
Yes. I think I've heard that part.
It's possible. Are you a demonstration?
I mean, what? A demonstration? You want a demonstration? Are you mad? Pay me.
No, I don't have money.
Then you don't get a demonstration.
When they stop buying our records, then I'll say goodbye and do something else. Become a strip artist or something.
Yeah? To what music you would strip? What music would you use?
All the songs I've written. Oh, man, come on.
I can see that coming. When
one of them writes a song that...
If I don't like it...
Do you
it,
like the lyrics? Yeah, that's what I was going to say.
I'm not going to sit there and say, yes, the song's good, it's not good.
They come and tell you that.
Of course, they do.
I tell them to fuck off. You want me to give a demonstration? Come here, it's much better in Portuguese, isn't it? I can understand you, see? You know, because I knew what you said before.
What's the fresh element now in the new tour that
you're doing? My costume.
It's a message song, or a charisma. It
looks so bored in that interview.
I know you don't think this, but a girl is going to pop out of that. Try.
How would you describe yourself as an artist? Would you say that you're a very organized person, a very spontaneous person, or how would you say?
No, myself as an artist, I'm just a musical prostitute, my dear.
Oh, that was awesome. That wink at the end, I love that. Thank you all for watching. Please like, comment, subscribe. Click the notification button to get notified for new and upcoming reaction videos. My Facebook is at Have a Very Nice Day. And as always, thank you all for watching. I'm going to have to try to find the part 2 because it'll be hilarious. I have to watch it. But thank you all for